Hello, everybody. Great to see you. Welcome today. You know, when we get along with other people, it can just be so harmonious and peaceful, and we could just enjoy this beautiful earth, this life that God's given to us. But sadly and unfortunately, as human beings, we may just have constant conflicts with one another. Maybe perhaps it stems from conflicts within us. You know, the tone of voice that we may use as we talk to others or in conversations matters a great deal. Even the tone of voice, how we talk to ourselves, appear in our mind. It can be a critical tone, or it can be a very pleasing, pleasant tone, wonderful, delightful tone to the ears. But we have that choice, and it all stems with our heart. In Ezekiel, it says that God, take away this stony heart and give me a heart of flesh. Maybe some of us needs to soften our hearts today if we want to progress forward in our lives and not hold on to the conflicts we have had in the past with a certain individual, something that we've had a resentment that has been building up, the unforgiveness from years ago, and we can feel stuck. Well, in this video, I hope and pray that you may be encouraged to be set free, that your hearts may be softened, that you may be able to have that joy and live the fulfilled life that God promises to give to each and every one of us. But we have to do our part. We are responsible for our own happiness, not for other people. No, let us take care of ourselves, because we have the control to change our views, our ways, our tone of voice as we talk to others. We cannot change another person, but we can only change ourselves. I like to share this quote with you, and it says, I can't control anyone else, but I can control myself. My thoughts, my words, my choices, my actions, my reactions, and my future. So there is nobody to blame. As believers in Christ, God wants us to first of all be filled with His love. And therefore, we're able, when we fill up our tank with His love, then we're able to see more clarity with the other individual that we are in constant conflict with. Maybe we harbored some type of unforgiveness within our hearts because we may have been sensitive or offended by another person. We may have been hurt over and over again. And you wonder, why do I feel so stuck? And something is just setting me back. I can't seem to be free and move forward in my job or in my relationship with others or within myself. I cannot excel or propel onto another level. Well, perhaps we all know that when we have unforgiveness in our hearts towards another human being, it's like us just drinking the poison. It's doing nothing to the other person, but we ourselves are just being diseased from that poison of resentment, hatred, bitterness, and ongoing unforgiveness from another person. But I pray that you may take control and be responsible, that you have the power to change yourself in so many different areas in your life, especially with that person you are in conflict with. You know, as human beings, we all have our own belief systems. We have our own upbringing, whatever it may look like. When we talk to one another, we may strongly believe one way, and then the other person may believe their own thoughts, and then we can just have so much friction and just clash. No, my way is right. No, my way is the right way. I know this with all my heart. Maybe it's a culture we have been brought up with. Maybe it's a gender difference, men, women, how we think. It can be so many different things. And I like to give you a little example. There was a father and a son that entered a store, and they were both wearing sunglasses. The father were wearing glasses with blue color lens on it. The son was wearing sunglasses with pink color lens on it, let's say. They walk into the store and on the mannequin was a white shirt. And as they entered the store, both father and son saw that white shirt. The father wearing the blue color glasses says, "Oh wow, look at that blue shirt, that nice blue shirt on that mannequin there." But the son saw it and said, "Oh no, Dad, that's not a blue color shirt, that's a pink color shirt," because the son was wearing pink color glasses on his lens. But they both strongly believe and they started fighting. "No, that's not a pink shirt, that's a blue shirt. That's not a blue shirt, that's a pink shirt." But they strongly were convicted with their own belief. This is the way. And they were not open-minded to any kind of other possibilities. Maybe it's time for you to take off your glasses and to have more clarity of what is really the truth behind the conflict you are dealing with today. It can be so many different things. Maybe it's time for you to change your lens and to view everybody through the lens of God's love, through His perception of all people that He created. The humanity that God's created, He wants us to tap into our innate spirit, which is full of God's love. And I pray that you may have more of an open and willing heart to settle the matter of any kind of ugly conflict you may be dealing with today with that certain individual, that the friction is there and it's just not sitting well with you. But I pray that God may soften your heart today and get and cast out the heart of stone. So again, check the tone of voice. How is your tone of voice as you talk to others? Is it pleasant and kind? Or is it harsh and rude and you just feel annoyed and you're frustrated and irritated and you're more sharp with your tone of voice? As we know, we can use our tone of voice and it can send a message to the other person as they listen on. For instance, if a husband comes home for dinner and he smells his wife is cooking in the kitchen, he can go in the kitchen and look at the pan, what she's cooking, and say, "What's this?" With those two words, I mean. Or he could come in the kitchen and look with inquisitive and curiosity, "What's this?" Those are the same two words, but the expression and the tone of voice portrays a different message when the person is hearing it. So when you talk to that individual, check your tone of voice and check your heart attitude. That will make a tremendous difference in the conversation you have with others. And I'd like to share with you a quote from Rebecca Helen. And she says, "Be selective in your battles. Sometimes peace is better than being right." So sometimes, you know, it's not worth the battles. It's a wasted time, energy, efforts. We exhaust ourselves and always having war and conflict with another person. Ask yourself, is it really, really worth it? But then again, a quote from Jordan Peterson says, "Conflict delayed is conflict multiplied." So sometimes when we avoid the conflict that is bothering us, when we get hurt from another individual, it can just multiply over time. And I'd like to share with you an example. You know, in the early years being married to my husband, I'm the kind of person who do not like conflict. I avoid conflicts. I hate just really loud voices or shoutings of unkind, of any of that type of just loudness. It just really bothers me. So any kind of conflict, I avoid. So little things that my husband Andy may have said or done in the past, I would express it, but sometimes I would just be quiet and sweep everything under the rug. Well, over time, as you can imagine, that rug just got built up higher and higher. And one day I thought to myself, "Wow, I'm noticing in my heart I am having an arm's distance with my husband. I cannot connect with him intimately. I don't feel that he is approachable. So over time, I said, this is not good. I'm headed not in a good direction. That unforgiveness and that bitterness and resentment just kept festering up in my heart. And I had to take action and do something about this. And I pray to God, please God, give me wisdom and discernment. And please give me the opportune right time that you know that you can give to Andy and I, that we can have that difficult conversation, because I don't want it to continue on and be stuck and be resented from years back. I want to progress and move forward, which I hope all of you do too at the same time. And I'd like to share with you this quote that may help you. And it says, Peter Blumberg says, when we avoid difficult conversations, we trade short-term discomfort for long-term dysfunction. So that's what happened with me. I kept avoiding that difficult conversation talking with my husband because I was afraid maybe how he was going to react. I thought he was going to just, you know, like lash out, and I was just scared of him. And again, I couldn't approach him if he was maybe in a mood that was displeasing to me. So again, I kept quiet, but it led to dysfunction. So another quote I like to share with you, no longer responding or reacting to people who trigger you is one of the ways you can strengthen your spiritual muscles. So boy, did I need to like push up my sleeves and start strengthening my spiritual muscles and have faith, because I didn't want to be triggered in the same old pattern, the same old way constantly. Again, I want to live this fulfilled life that Jesus came to give to all of us. And I encourage you, let us just let go of whatever problem that is bothering you. Or pray to ask God, give me the opportune time with wisdom and guidance and discernment. When is the right time to be able to have the difficult conversation with that individual that you have been in friction with, that you may have more peace and harmony? So finally, there was an opportune time that I was able to talk with Andy, and boy, was he blown away when I shared and expressed my feelings of how I buried deep down inside. He was just shocked. He didn't think there was no problem with us, but I just kept harboring that. So I pray that if it is in God's will, and when you are aligned with His Spirit, you will have the right tone of voice and a soft heart to have that difficult conversation with another. But then again, to have that discernment and wisdom, maybe select your battles. Maybe if it's not worth it, you know, certain frictions, then just let it pass and go for peace. Let peace guide you. That is just something that you have to listen to, the still small voice from God's Spirit speaking to you, when I should talk, when I should not talk, and just look at the situation, step back and look at it like the white shirt, like the father and son. They need to take off their glasses because they believe that they were right. And they strongly believe, no, that shirt is blue color. No, that shirt is pink color. But in actuality, it's white color. So pray to ask God to give you more clarity in the situation. When we're so, we're so distracted, or we're so faded out with so much of the hurt and wounds, it's hard to see with clarity. But pray that God will give you more of a clear vision and choose to see all things through the eyes of God's love today. So in this situation, just refrain from it. Take a step back and choose to reframe it. Choose to see it in a different perspective. A better, more joyful perspective, because all of us are walking around with wounds from our past. We're not walking in, we're not being led by God's Spirit, but we are being led by the wounds. And when we're so wounded and we're not dealing with those rooted issues from our past, then they say hurt people hurt others, and you just cannot help it. But we are all here to heal ourselves through God's Spirit, and hopefully to encourage others and to heal them as well, to make this world a better place. Let us do our part to contribute, to show more of God's love and peace and His light to others. I'd like to share with you some Bible verses. And it says in Proverbs 15:1, it says, "A gentle answer turns away wrath, but a harsh word stirs up anger." And I'd like to share with you Proverbs 12:18. And it says, "The words of the reckless pierce like swords, but the tongue of the wise brings healing." I'd like to share with you Proverbs 16:7. And it says, "When the Lord takes pleasure in anyone's way, He causes their enemies to make peace with them." That is just so true. I remember years ago, I had a little friction and conflict with these two sisters. And years went by, but somehow, with God's love and His grace and mercy, even the enemies in my own world, who I thought were my enemies, God made peace, and now we became good friends. It is crazy. God surely works in mysterious ways. Allow God to manifest in your heart and to work in you and to the other person. Only God can move and change the other person's heart. Again, we are responsible to change ourselves. We cannot control and change another human being. You would just only frustrate yourselves and be miserable, unhappy. So when you, again, if you know better, don't expect the other person to make the first move to reconcile. If you know better, you take charge and you make the first move. Again, with God softening your heart, with your tone of voice, and with more peace and clarity, and just put bygones to bygones, and to see all things through God's light, through His white shirt, that He may bring more peace and forgiveness amongst the two of you that you have been having this ongoing conflict with. And I'd like to share with you John 13:34, and it says, "A new command I give to you, which is love. Love one another as I have loved you, so you must love one another." That is God's command. God wants us to love Him, love ourselves, and love others. And you will see, when you please and honor God in your life, and He commands you to love others, blessings galore will come your way. That is a guarantee. But when you are resistant, and you have so much anger and hate, and you're so annoyed with that other person, you are doing a disservice to yourself, and you are just prolonging any kind of joy and happiness and peace that you can have. It's just an arm's length and you can reach it, but you have to do your part. And once you do, take that deep breath, be the bigger person, and allow God's love to manifest in your heart. You will see the rewards and blessings come in so many different ways. Like these two sisters, we became great friends. Who would have thought from years ago, when I just always kept my arms distance, because we have personality clashes and different beliefs, whatever it may be. But hey, people change. We can change. And I pray that God may change and do a transformation in your heart and in your spirit today. And it says in Ephesians 4:29, "Do not let any unwholesome talk come out of your mouths, but only what is helpful or building, for building others up according to their needs, that it may benefit those who listens." God just wants us to keep on building others up. Again, when we are so hurt and wounded, it's so hard for us to make the first move. But pray that God will give you the wisdom and discernment today to live that joy-filled life. It's at your reach. And that let bygones be bygones. And I love this quote, unknown quote. "Once you develop that it is what it is mentality, a lot of things stop bothering you." It is what it is mentality. Just let it go. Let us not try to control the situation or the other person. We're all so different. Our upbringings are different. Our culture are different. Our religion, our beliefs, our politics, or whatever it may be. There is so much division, but let us not be part of that. Let us be that person to be used by God to bring peace, unity, and harmony amongst others. And another quote, never trust your tongue when your heart is bitter or broken. Hush until you are healed. Shh. Some of us want to just lash out and project any kind of things that are stirring up within, hatred, anger, bitterness, division, chaos, our strong beliefs, no, my way's the right way. But just hush until you are healed. Pray that God may do an inner work in your heart and in your spirit today. Just don't repay evil by evil, but do not be overcome by evil, but overcome evil with good. Let us be that person to be used as children of God to have more peace and harmony, to have more wisdom, guidance, and discernment, so there may be more peace and it can be a ripple effect. Once you're in conflict with the others, when they see your change of attitude, your change, your tone of voice, your change of heart, and you can be a wonderful example, a role model, and as a believer in Christ, and you can help that person to scratch their head and think, wow, something about that person has changed. And maybe, maybe not, that person may change for the better too. But it's not up to you to change that person. What is between that friction is not with that person, but is between you and God. Look up to God and make it right first and foremost with our Heavenly Father, and just please and honor Him in all things. And once you do, once you know better and choose to see everything through the eyes of that white shirt, take off those colored lenses, but ask God to give you more clarity today to do the right thing. God bless you, and I hope that something I said today may help to encourage you to just soften your heart, to make better choices, to be the bigger person, to overcome evil with good, and until you are healed. Pray for God to give you wisdom and guidance for the opportune time if you need to talk with the other individual, that God may give you the words of wisdom to bring more healing, love, and forgiveness today, and guarantee blessings galore may come your way. God bless you, and I'll see you next week. Goodbye.